Today our lab 7 is about the select queries and we are targeting to understand the distinct aliases and reading of data from multiple tables, filtering data or searching in data based on some patterns, and then at the end we will see the order by query. So let's start. The prerequisite for this lab is that you have already done lab 6 and you have created the Dream Home database. In case you have not created it, you should have that query. I will share it with you in lab 6 over here. And the second step is that your script file that I told you last time to generate it should be able to perform these tasks in that script file, to create and drop any database by only providing the name of the database. Create and drop tables of Dream Home database. Since we are specific to this case study, so we'll be focusing this one. Insert queries that will add your sample data to the database Dream Home. So I can show you a sample of this. Like you should have a file something like this one, where you can see that you have the create database queries. Then you are selecting it, and then you have to create the tables, these common tables, and then you insert some sample data. You can insert it individually, or you can insert multiple values in one query like this, and then some example for staff. Your today's lab task is to have at least like 50 rows of data in each table that you create for the Dream Home case study. Okay, so let's get back to the lab. Our first target today is to understand the distinct and alias keywords, how they are working. So distinct keyword before the columns, distinct keyword before any column name, eliminate duplicate values and return only different values. So to see this in action, we have these two queries in where we are using distinct keyword in the second one. So if you can see over here, this is our lab 7. So let's execute it, both of them at the same time. So now you see that the first query is duplicating the values ISB, ISB and ABT, NBT and so on and so forth. But the second query, where I have written the distinct before the city column, you can see that none of these are duplicated. Okay, so this is how distinct is working. The next option is aliases. Okay, so alias is like a nickname or like another name that you can give to the column or that you can give to any table. So it provides you a way to give a different name to a table, column or any derived column in the results. The name are only applicable for results. They do not affect the metadata of the tables. Only in the result you will show that change, okay, like the header of the columns will be changed, but they are not actually permanently saved in the database. So to understand this, let's run these examples. I can show you them over here, the alias example. Let's run them like the first two one, and you can see that in the first query I have not given any alias to the city, but in the second one I have given it's a nickname like my city. So you see my city is written here. Over here by default it is the actual column name that is there in the table, so I have given an alias to the column name. Let's also run the other two examples. So you can see that, okay, we have an ID. We first name is like first name, last name is like last name, position, and we have sex is gender, and date of birth is date of birth, salary is income, and all these alias names are appearing over here in the result, right? So they are not actually permanently changed back in the metadata of this table, but they are just shown in the result like this. So this is how you give aliases to your columns or your tables. So the third part of the lab is let's switch back to the lab. Okay, the SQL file for this lab is already like that I am showing you over here. It is already available online. You can just click it over here and it will take you to the actual file. You can directly use that. Okay, now let's see the filtering of data, how you filter the records. Filtering of data based on a single and compound conditions. You can select data of your choice from all rows of a table by specifying a condition using a where class in the select command. So a where class is actually doing the filtering. Okay, so if you want to do like a row selection, we want to select some of the rows and not the other ones. So the basic search conditions we have, there is some typo mistake, I will fix it. So these are the basic five types of where class comparison options that you have, like comparison, compare the values of one expression to the value of another expression, and then if the expression meets the condition that is true, then those rows will be picked, otherwise they will not be picked. Another option is the range text, whether the values of an expression falls within a specified range of values, okay. Like if you say that, okay, if the in the staff, if the role is manager or supervisor, pick the rows. If not, then don't pick those rows, okay, you just skip them. The third option is like set membership test, whether the values of an expression equals one of a set of values. So you can directly specify the values. If the values is set, then you say that, okay, select that row. If the values not set or not in that set, so you don't pick up that values. The fourth one is pattern matching. So we will also look into its example below. The pattern match test, whether a string match a specified pattern or not. So you can also do search based on do filtering based on the some specific pattern. We will have its example later on. Null test, whether a column has a null unknown value, not existence of value, okay, or if there is any value. I can also specify the I can filter the columns based on the null values. In SQL, the comparison operators are these ones, okay, these six operators, seven operators. The equal operator, the not equal operator. The not equal is allowed, okay, these are actually six operators, but this is a different version and different DBMSs allowed in some dialects, means some DBMSs. In SQL Server you will use the not equal to this one, so there are actually six operators. This is less than, like you do in programming, so those condition operators are also available over here. More complex predicate can be generated using the logical operators, okay. You can use these keywords like AND, OR, and NOT with parentheses if needed or desired to show the order of evaluation. The rules for evaluating conditions expressions are: an expression is evaluated left to right. Sub expressions and brackets are evaluated first. NOTs are evaluated before AND and ORs. So NOT conditions, NOT logical operators are evaluated before these two. Okay, the highest priority is with the NOTs, and AND is evaluated before the ORs. So this is the priority, like first NOTs and then ANDs and then ORs. These are the logical operators priority, you should be able to understand them. So now we have again some example for filtering the data. On Dream database you can run these queries and see the results. So let's see, we run those queries, the third part, like we run them in in pair up two. So you see the first one is select these columns from the stop table where salary is greater than 10,000. So you see the salary column is all the values are greater than 10,000. And the second one I am filtering based on the value, okay. So I say that if the city is Islamabad or the city is Abbottabad, only select those rows, okay. Select static from branch table where city is Islamabad or city is Abbottabad, etc. So you see only Islamabad record, and there is no record of ATD, so none of them are appearing here. So you can feed more data to have more more set of records for this table. Let's execute the other one, these two examples. So you say that select staff number, first name, last name, position, salary from the staff table, where salary is between the 20,000 and 30,000. So you see 30,000 or 24,000, so they are between, both are between the 20 and 30,000, inclusive. Okay, so these values are inclusive in the results. And the second query says that okay, select the values from the staff where salary is greater than 20,000 and salary is less than or equal to the 20,000. So the same record almost. If we remove this equal to and we say that only 30 should be less than 30,000, so you can see the result, only one record is appearing. Okay, the next two rows, let's execute them. We are filtering based on the position, like if the position in the column is either manager or it is supervisor, then select those rows, otherwise don't select them. So you see only three records are there, one is supervisor and two are managers. If you don't want to have these values filtered, then you can see all the records. You see we have all these records at the moment in this table. So assistant records were skipped. Okay, and another way is that we want to select those rows from the staff where position is manager or the position is supervisor. So this is almost similar to this condition, like the data will be similar, but another way of writing the same query. Okay, there can be a lot of alternate flavors for generating the same type of information in SQL Server. So again three queries. So now the fourth part of our lab is pattern based searching. SQL has two special pattern matching symbols, one is percentage and another is underscore. Percentage is percentage character represent any sequence of zeros or more characters, wildcard, we call it a wildcard character. Okay, in some DBMSs it is star. I think in SQL Server you may be specifying it as a star, is the star character is actually the wildcard character, but in SQL Server we have percentage for the wildcard character, and this represent any zero or any sequence of characters. Okay, we will see this in example. Another one is underscore. Underscore represent only one character, right? It can be anyone, any character, but only one character. So these two are the pattern matching two main characters. For example, if we write like h percent this, so it means that a column value where the first character is h and there could be any number of zero or more characters after the h. Address like the address is a column and we say the address like h and there are four underscores, so this means that there must be exactly four characters in the string, the first of which must be an h and the rest of three can be anything. Okay, so we have actually three underscores here, not four. Another example is address like percent e, so you say any word that is ending at character e. Okay, and percent Glasgow and percent, it means there is something in the middle, in the middle Glasgow must be present and there can be any character in the beginning or at the end. And h percent mean any character after the h. Okay, so these are the examples. And now let's run few example, like we say that okay, select from the staff from a private owner where address is like this, or select client and view data from viewing table where property number is PG14 and comment is null. Okay, so you are also selecting based on the null character. There could be also a lot of other examples we will go through. So let's see if we have an example here. Pattern based searching examples are not enough, so because there is no data I think in the private owner table, so you don't see any result. So that's why I have asked you that you should feed enough data in your tables to see the proper result of all these queries. Okay, and this query is from the viewing table, so you should also put some data in the viewing table. and then run this query, it will show you the results. The fifth part of today's lab is reading data from multiple tables. So you can read data from multiple tables by separating tables names by a comma. Note that if you do not specify a condition, then result will be a cross multiplication of the tables and may result into invalid rows. Therefore, to generate meaningful information, we should have some condition among the tables. Like if I say that, okay, select steric from branch comma staff, so each branch will be concatenated with every row of the staff and then presented to you. So maybe there is a branch without those staffs, but you are showing the staff which is not in actually in those branches, so those are invalid values. So to avoid this thing, you add this condition, like you say that the branch number must be equal to the staff branch number, so the invalid rows will be eliminated and only correct values will be shown to you. Now we will run them shortly. Another example is select steric from branch ASB. We are using aliasing over here, okay, for writing our query easily. And staff is S, where B dot branch number is equal to S dot branch number. Instead of writing the complete name of tables, we have used the aliases. And one more option in SQL Server is that if you skip this S, it will still consider S as an alias, okay. Select steric from branch ASB. So these are some more queries, and you can just run them and see their results. So let's run the first two ones. So you see the table is multiplied, and there are so many columns. We have 42 result. Okay, so every branch is actually multiplied with every row of the staff, and you have so many result, but the actual valid values are actually only 6 values, okay. So there are 6 staff members working in any branch. So these are the valid values, and the 42, so 36 are invalid records in this case because of the condition that we add on the branch number must be equal, okay. So in the next two examples, so the last two examples, last part of the lab, let's go through that part quickly. Understanding the order by class. So this is the last topic of the lab, and this actually what order by is doing is used with select query to sort the result in ascending or descending order on any column, on more than one columns, okay. So like for this examples, select city from branch order by city. So if it is an string value, it will be alphabetically sorted. If it is integer, it will be numerically sorted. And if it is even a date, it will be date wise sorted, okay. Minimum date first and maximum later on. If you want to do that by descending order, so it is done here for the city. Let me also execute these two examples, and then we end up with the demonstration of the lab. Then we will just go through a few exercises that I'll be giving to you. You see over here, select distinct city from branch order by city descending. So the A is at the end, and D and H and I and M. But over here by default it is an ascending order, and it is like A first, B is, there is no B record, D and so on and so forth. So you can sort, you can order your records based on any column or more than one column. You can give a comma, and then you can give the name of other columns. So it will be first sorted by this, and then by the second one, and then by the second one. Like if the value is same, like in ABT case, so then these two records will be sorted based on the second column. So that's it for today's lab, and the lab task for you guys is that you need to find out the solution for the exercises. Like you need to find the queries for these simple exercises. Print the list of postcode without any repetition. You have to use the distinct before the postcode. Print all last name from staff without repetition. List all staff with renaming all its columns and results. List all clients with renaming all its columns to synonyms. like the column names, okay, not the data. List all staff with a salary greater than 10,000. We already have this example in that we just saw. List all managers and supervisors. So we also have examples of this one. We already saw that one. So that's it for the lab. And the good thing will be, like, if you can come up with more meaningful information from this set of data using these five concepts. Okay. So that's it for the demonstration of this lab. If there is any questions, we will discuss that in question answer session.